Okay, there are lots of misconceptions about G-Sync, FreeSync, and V-Sync, especially when it comes to how to set everything up for the lowest latency possible. Some people say you should never turn on any type of sync for competitive games, or else you increase your latency.
So using any type of sync causes slight input lag. So don't use any syncs if your GPUs are strong enough.
And you basically just want to look for any settings that has the word sync in it. So for example, I have a setting called FreeSync. I make sure I uncheck that.
Some say you should enable both G-Sync and V-Sync at the same time. And some people say you should never even think about enabling V-Sync because it will increase your latency by a lot.
Now, I don't recommend using V-Sync because it will always lead to higher input delay.
Turn this trash off.
And you know, the tricky part is there's some truth about each of these statements. You can definitely increase your latency a lot with the wrong settings. Poorly configured, G-Sync can easily double or triple your end-to-end latency, but this is a worst case versus best case kind of comparison, and there's definitely more nuance to this. I've measured a lot of different settings combinations, and we're gonna go over the settings you should be using and the settings you should absolutely avoid in a minute. But why do you even want to use Adaptive Sync in the first place? Well, Adaptive Sync, aka G-Sync or FreeSync, depending on which brand of GPU you're using, syncs your monitor and your graphics card. And that has some key benefits. I'm using a NVIDIA GPU and my setup is not configured to use G-Sync right now. So both my monitor and my PC are putting out frames as fast as they can. The monitor is doing 240Hz and the GPU is pushing roughly double that in FPS. So I'm getting a lot of so-called tearing. The GPU just spits out a new frame whenever it's ready and the monitor just can't keep up. It often gets a new frame mid-refresh and then just abandons the old frame and continues with a new one. So with each monitor refresh, I'm getting a mix of older and newer frame pieces, which sometimes can look like the image is torn apart. Visually, that's not ideal. In-game, this happens multiple times per second, and the end result often looks kind of similar to compression artifacts. Definitely not something that's pleasing to look at. But still, lots of people play their competitive games this way, because in theory, this gives you the lowest latency possible. The monitor just displays whatever the GPU has ready at the given moment, which intuitively sounds like this would give you the lowest latency possible. In contrast, Adaptive Sync implies that the GPU has to wait for the monitor to finish a frame, or the other way around. So it's easy to see where the idea comes from that Adaptive Sync increases your latency. And you'll definitely increase your latency if you're using pure V-Sync. Historically, this was the only option to sync the monitor and GPU, but this typically adds quite a few milliseconds of additional latency compared to just running uncapped FPS and default settings with every kind of sync turned off. But actually, in Overwatch, the default settings with everything turned off don't get you the lowest latency you can get. You can easily cut that down by a few milliseconds, even with G-Sync on. And there are two ways you can configure G-Sync that both result in a low end-to-end latency. What you do not want to do is cap your FPS at the max refresh rate of your monitor. Unfortunately, that's still something that's being recommended a lot online, like a 240 FPS cap for a 240Hz monitor and so on. Don't do that, please. You're not actually going to be using G-Sync or FreeSync that way. A cap at the maximum refresh rate is not low enough to ensure that the FPS stay inside of the Adaptive Sync range all the time. You will see tearing in this case, at the very least at the bottom edge of your monitor.
To get rid of that, some people recommend that you enable V-Sync in conjunction to G-Sync. And while it is true that this eliminates tearing completely, that V-Sync part is a bit tricky. G-Sync is on right now, and you notice that enabling V-Sync automatically caps the FPS to the maximum refresh rate of the monitor, or just a frame below that, like 239 FPS here on my 240Hz monitor, without even using an FPS limiter. So it worked, right? Well, the tricky part is that this is actually just like using pure V-Sync without G-Sync.
And you might be running these settings without even knowing that. But you can see that in the latency numbers. It's about 25, 26 milliseconds of latency, no matter if G-Sync is on or off. So G-Sync did not help here, and configured like this, it is just as bad as using pure V-Sync. And that's because G-Sync is basically acting like V-Sync in this configuration. In order to actually use G-Sync as intended, and in order to avoid the latency penalty, you have to make sure that the FPS stay inside of the Adaptive Sync range of your monitor so the G-Sync actually kicks in. The simplest, most convenient way to do this is by just enabling NVIDIA Reflex inside the game. If G-Sync and V-Sync are on, enabling Reflex acts just like an FPS limiter. Reflex on plus boost is typically the setting you want to run. And this will get you very low latency G-Sync. Now, on a 240Hz monitor, Reflex caps at 224fps, so quite a few frames below 240. So it can be worth it to use a manual FPS cap to squeeze out a few more frames. This is the second method you can use to configure G-Sync for low latency. The latency numbers are very comparable with both methods, but the good thing about using a manual FPS limiter is that it doesn't require your game to support Reflex, and you get a few more FPS. A cap just 3fps below the maximum refresh rate of your monitor is enough. This makes sure that both G-Sync and V-Sync work as intended with no additional latency. Preferably, you want to use the in-game FPS limiter for that, but a good third-party program like RTSS or the limiter inside the NVIDIA driver also do the job. Now, both the FPS cap and the Reflex method work great and result in roughly the same end-to-end latency. And in both Overwatch and Valorant, the latency is lower that way than running uncapped FPS with everything turned off. Overwatch benefits more than Valorant here because it's much more limited by the GPU, and that's where limiting the frame rate really helps. However, you can get an even slightly lower latency by running uncapped FPS with NVIDIA Reflex. The effect is smaller for sure, but both Overwatch and Valorant show a slight latency reduction compared to the G-Sync configurations. And this makes sense when you take a look at how a monitor actually displays an image. Monitors do not just show new images all at once. Instead, they start at the top and render line by line and pixel by pixel until they reach the bottom of the screen. So while a monitor that's using adaptive sync starts drawing a frame and keeps drawing the same frame for the whole refresh cycle, a monitor that's not configured to use adaptive sync will abandon the original frame as soon as it gets a new frame from the GPU and will start drawing that instead. So if your frame rate is higher than the refresh rate of your monitor, the lower parts of the screen will show bits of more recent frames. It's up for debate though how useful this really is. Like, does seeing the reload animation a fraction of a millisecond earlier actually give you an advantage in game? I mean, there's typically not a whole lot of info on the bottom part of your screen that would be beneficial if you could see it just a little earlier. At crosshair level, which is where I measured these latency numbers, the latency advantage is small. I highly recommend to everyone to try both uncapped FPS and adaptive sync and see for yourself which you prefer. Just make sure to use the right settings. Thanks for watching. Bis zum nächsten Video.